I got soul. Shalom, Yasharala. This is your brother Malachi coming at you with a quick video. But first and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah, Kadash, and in the ancient Hebrew tongue, that's the name of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, and His begotten Son, our Savior, Yahweh Shai. I also want to give double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone for teaching this truth and having 100% truth, and the like men on the highways and byways teaching the like doctrine, feeding the sheep, diligently putting up videos throughout the week. Shalom to you. Okay, so this is going to be just, you know, a quick lesson. Been meditating on this, you know, all day. And it's about faith, okay? Faith is a major key in the times that we live in, okay? And understanding, you know, the knowledge that we have, okay? Because when you look outside of your door, okay, all you see is Esau, the so-called white man's world, his vision. Death, destruction, confusion, and if you're not grounded, okay, in the foundation of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, you can get easily caught up into believing in this world, okay? Believing in the wiles of the devil, okay? And you can also you can ultimately become a reprobate, you know? If Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai deem so, you know? But that's why faith and prayer goes hand in hand in this thing. You know, and I'm speaking from experience, okay? And actually, let me start off by getting the definition of faith. This is Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So if you have faith, you have belief on something that is not seen, okay? You have a hope for something that is not seen, something that is not here yet. That's why we are prisoners of hope, because we believe Yahweh Shai is going to return, restore order, okay, and put the so-called Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans at the top of society, at the top of government, okay? We believe and we have faith on these things. It says, I'm going to jump down to verse 6. It says, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to Yahweh must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Okay, so if you're going to be a believer in Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, then you're going to understand and you're going to believe that he is a rewarder of those that seek him. And how do you seek him? You seek him through going out, putting up videos throughout the week. Okay, you seek him through going out to the highways and byways, okay, studying, preaching and prophesying in the face of your oppressors, okay? You're seeking Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. You got to understand, no one on this planet is doing the work except 144,000 men right now. No one is even meditating on Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. So you have a whole world that's covered in wickedness, okay? That's why when we see these things, you know, if you look from a numbers aspect, we're outnumbered, okay? As far as righteousness versus wickedness. But that's where faith comes into play, man. Because you believe on something. You believe on the word, first off. You believe on the scriptures, okay? But through the scriptures, you also have faith in these things to come, man. That's why we were sent the Comforter. I believe it's John 14 and 1 that tells us that, okay? It says, by faith, and it's going to give us examples. It says, by faith, Noah being warned of Yahweh of the things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemneth the world, and became heir of the righteousness, which is by faith. So Noah, he was warned of Yahweh, okay, of things to befall the earth, that there was a great flood. Now, before that, there was no such thing as liquid coming out the sky, man. Okay? of particles of water coming from the sky. So Noah had ultimate faith, man. He was ridiculed. He was mocked. Now, what does that sound like today? That sounds like the prophets of today. We're telling you of the impending, you know, forecast for America and the world. The president, Trump, just came out and said that, told everyone to not believe on the prophets of doom and their apocalyptic views of the world. Okay? Now, did we lose faith because he said that? No. We believe. We believe on something that we can't see right now, but we know it's going to happen, and that's a gift. That's a part of, that's a spiritual gift, brothers and sisters. Not everyone has faith. And see, Esau has made a world to where faith is non-existent. Why? Because he wants you to think carnally. He wants you to say seeing is believing. Okay? If I don't see it, then it ain't true. If I can't get it now, then I don't want it. I'm going to finish up. It says, this is Hebrews 11 and 8. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed, and he went out, not knowing whether he went. Yeah, so Abraham, okay, he went out to a place that he was going to receive for an inheritance, okay? Now, did he say, okay, when I get there, am I going to have my inheritance as soon as I get there? No, he had faith that all things that Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai told him would happen, man. That is a true gift. And that's why we have to have that faith, that armor of faith continually on us, man. And it goes, like I said, it goes hand in hand with prayer, which is a future video that I'm going to do. But those things go hand in hand, man. Like I said, if you don't have faith, you would think that the numbers are against us, that the odds are stacked against us, okay? Oh, please, you know, there's going to be no man coming from the sky with quote-unquote UFOs. Man, what are y'all talking about, you know? Oh, you people aren't a people. You damn sure ain't the people of the Most High, you know? All of these things that we hear constantly. And then being in a world that is contrary to our beliefs. That's where that faith kicks in. And that's why we have to continually preach Salaki. We have to continually pray and thank Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai for giving us that faith. Because that is a true gift, man. It's a true gift. This is like I said, this is a quick lesson and I'm going to end it up. This is 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7. For we walk by faith and not by sight. Yeah. Akiam wa akwath. We walk by faith and not by sight. Because if we walked by sight, then guess what? We would have been gave up. Okay? Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, he wouldn't have had no men, okay, to stand firmly and to stand boldly for him. Because like I said, the world is contrary to Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. So if we walk by sight, we would say, you know what, this isn't happening. The economy, you know, one day it's negative 400 points, the next day it's, you know, positive 300 points, you know. Oh, this, you know, the World War III, it's not coming, man, you know. Oh, the coronavirus, I thought it was going to be way bigger than it is. You know, all of these things, if we actually walked by sight, okay, we could say. And we could lose faith with the quickness, man. But Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, he's put that spirit upon us to walk by faith, okay, and not by sight. And that is a true gift. That is a true gift, brothers and sisters. So I pray that this lesson was edifying. Like I said, I just wanted to have a quick, do a quick lesson in the spirit. Call Halal Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah, Kadash, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai. This is your brother Malachi signing off.